As expected, Google announced the new Nexus 7 last week. The question now is, can it fill the shoes of its predecessor? Better yet, is it worth the upgrade or $230? I'm Taylor Martin, this is Pocket Now, and this is our full review of the new Nexus 7. The new Nexus 7 and old model have just enough in common to tell the two are related, but there is no mistaking how much more refined the new Nexus 7 truly is. ASUS quite literally improved all the sore points of the original Nexus 7 with the new model. It made the tablet nearly 6mm narrower, allowing the tablet to slip into coat and pant pockets more easily. The tablet is also 1.8mm thinner and 50 grams lighter for an overall 200mm tall, 114mm wide, 8.7mm thick, and 290 grams. Even for a 7-inch tablet, the Nexus 7 is small, and it fits quite easily in one hand. The contoured backside, which is composed of a high-quality soft-touch plastic, lends to the ability to palm the device easily. It doesn't attract fingerprints and allows you to get a nice firm grip on the tablet. Under the hood is where this tablet shines. No, the 1.5 GHz quad-core Snapdragon S4 Pro chipset is not the latest and greatest, but it's certainly no slouch either. It comes with 2GB of RAM, either 16 or 32GB of fixed storage, a 5MP camera around back, 1.2MP front camera, a 3950mAh battery, Qi wireless charging, NFC, and Wi-Fi BGN. It's also Bluetooth Smart Ready, and a T-Mobile, AT&T, and Verizon compatible LTE model will launch soon. The display is possibly the best part of this tablet. The contrast isn't the best, and the colors lack that certain pop we love so much. But this is the first tablet to feature a truly high-resolution display. The 7-inch IPS LCD panel features a resolution of 1920 by 1200 pixels for a total pixel density of 323 pixels per inch. It offers wide viewing angles, it's considerably bright, and it's notably more crisp and clear than any other like-sized tablet. As far as hardware goes, the Nexus 7 is spectacular. It feels great in the hands, and it certainly feels more high-end than its price tag alludes. The software is exactly what you would expect of a Nexus-branded tablet. It ships with the latest version of Android, version 4.3, and will always be among the first devices to receive over-the-air updates. We've gone over Android 4.3 a few times now, so we won't bore you with too many details. This version has all the things we've come to expect of recent versions of Android: Daydream mode, lock screen widgets, multi-user support, separated pull-down menus for quick toggles and notifications, and a gesture-based keyboard. One great new feature from Android 4.3, however, is multi-user support with restricted profiles. You can create multiple user accounts and restrict which applications those users can access. This is a fantastic feature for families who may share a single tablet. As far as the app situation goes, we're happy to see that the things are improving for Android tablets. Fortunately, the effect of running a phone application on a 7-inch tablet isn't nearly as bad as it is on a 10-inch counterpart. But we're happy to see that of the 30 or so applications we've installed on our Nexus 7, only two are not optimized for use with tablets. That's a far cry from just 1 year ago. We've been putting the Nexus 7 through the ringer for the last several days, and we've counted a total of one performance hiccup, which was during the initial setup process. The rest of our time with the Nexus 7 has been buttery smooth. Opening applications, switching apps, returning home, switching orientation, and scrolling is as polished as we've ever experienced on an Android tablet. We had no trouble playing various graphic-intensive games either. And this tablet's performance in synthetic benchmarks is nothing to scoff at. With last year's chipset under the hood, we never expected it to set any records, but its benchmark scores are quite impressive. The dual speakers face outward, making them perfect for cupping your hands around. But they aren't all that great. They're loud, but very tinny without a lot of depth. You'll probably fare better listening to media and playing games with headphones. But if you're going to use the dual speakers, at least they're not terribly easy to completely cover. Also, the camera isn't anything to get excited over. But what tablet camera is? We're glad it's there, as it may be useful for capturing documents. But the overall image quality is mediocre. The 5-megapixel camera offers washed out, grainy, dull images. Finally, battery life. The cell inside isn't giant, and sure, battery life while in use could be better. As usual, doing graphic intensive stuff will kill the battery quickly. But the standby time is phenomenal. Sitting for over 24 hours on standby, the Nexus 7 managed to drop only 5%. On extra heavy days, the battery should last you into the late evening, but on light days of use, you may only need to charge the tablet every other day. Add all of this up, and we're quite pleased. We'll venture to say that Google and ASUS have created one of the very best Android tablets ever. Best of all, it's cheaper than just about anything else out there, and its display is the highest resolution display on a small tablet to date. Frankly, if you're in the market for a new tablet, the new Nexus 7 should be near the top, if not at the very top, of your list of tablets to check out. We give the Nexus 7 an 8.7 out of 10. That's gonna do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, be sure to click the thumbs up button below and subscribe. Be sure to follow us in all the usual outlets, Twitter, Google+, and Facebook at Pocket Now. I'm Taylor Martin. You can find me on Twitter at CasperTech. I'll see you next time.